What's going on everyone, my name is Tom from Dread Labs, and today we're going to make an iridescent chrome material in Octane and Cinema 4D. Alright guys, so in the last tutorial we discovered how we made a chrome material in just the normal Cinema 4D. And today I want to show you guys some cool methods that you can use in Octane to create a similar material and, in my opinion, an even cooler material. So we got our skull here again. Let me just fire up Octane real quick. And as you can see, we don't have any materials applied yet whatsoever. So what we want to do is we want to make a reflective environment. And in the other tutorial on Cinema 4D, we already talked a little bit about HDRI maps. But basically, they are an environment that you can use for your objects to reflect into. So in our Octane Live here, we'll go to Objects, HDRI Environment. And we'll click this tag here on the top right. Yeah, you can see it right here. We click on image texture and we'll load in a texture. And for the sake of this tutorial, I'm gonna drag in a Tokyo image. I'm not sure who the original author is or illustrator is from this image. It's not an HDRI image, it's just something that I like the colors of. And I'm just gonna click no. And as you can see, we basically have a Tokyo like cyberpunk vibe-ish HDRI map now. But I wanna have the background removed from this. So what I wanna do is I'm gonna go to settings. Expand this menu here a little bit, and if I click on alpha channel, that should be fine. Anyways, we're gonna go to materials, create, and we're gonna create a metallic material, and we're gonna apply it to the skull. And already we get like a lot of cool details in there, but I want to rotate the edge of my image here because it's an HDRI image. There's like a seam there, so if we click on the tag here, we can just rotate the X position like this, and we can remove it to the back a little bit like that. Or alternatively, we can just use an HDRI map. So I got this industrial HDRI map, which only will give me like a green chrome material. But as you can see, this gives out a lot more detail. Let me just open the material editor for Octane and let's just add a little bit of roughness in there. As you can see, it gives a little bit more of a gold vibe, I guess. But you can just change the color of your HDRI map accordingly. But a cool thing that I want to show you guys in Octane is if we open our material here and we go to the film layer. We'll edit the float here and the film IOR. And so once we start playing with this, as you can see, you get that like iridescent effect. So now we got like this cyberpunk chrome skull basically ready to go. And if you want to have it a little bit lighter, we'll go to the Octane Sky tab here, or the Environment tag, sorry. So up the power, we should be able to get a little bit more light, yeah, as you can see. And now the cool thing is, always on Instagram, you can see these like really cool glares and glows, and we're going to apply those as well. So with objects, we're going to add an Octane camera. And we're going to make sure that we're watching through the Octane camera. We want to add a little bit of denoising, so we're going to go to Camera Imager, Enable Camera Imager. Spectral AI denoiser enable, and in the render settings I'm going to make sure that if we go to Octane here, Octane renderer, I'm going to go with the linear sRGB color space, and I'm going to use the denoise beauty pass, and here in the render passes we're going to go with denoise beauty. All right so as you can see, this will denoise anything if we had some. So now we're going to go to the post processing tab on the Octane camera. So we're going to click here, and on the post processing tab, and we'll click enable. And basically what we're gonna do is we're gonna like bump the bloom power and the glare power up. As you can see what's happening here. The more we up the bloom power, the more glow we'll get, and the glare power will increase the glares that you can see here. I don't want to have these too drastically. You can just increase the amount, like these will increase like the amount of stars that you have. So if we do this like 10, you'll see more, but I prefer to have these like lower, like 4 or something. The cutoff will basically determine like how far these will glow. So the more you put this on, as you can see, the shorter these will get. I like to put it at 0 just normally. And the glare angle, you can just decide on like which direction your glare is like glowing in. So yeah, now we're just gonna render this. And as you can see, as easy as that, in under like even 7 minutes, we just created this. It's a little bit over the top, I know, but I just wanted to give you an example of what this Octane renderer is capable of. I've been using this for a few months now, I think since like February or something, and I just love working in it. It takes a while to get used to, but I just wanted to share this quick tutorial on how to create a chrome material and an iridescent material. So if you want to get a chrome material without like the whole iridescent thing, you can just go and put the flow to 0 again. And now if we render this, we should be able to get like a super white skull, and that's because we have the sky here, the light power set to 8, so we'll put this to 1 again. And we'll render this now, and this will get a chrome look, as you can see. So yeah, basically that's pretty much it, guys. Thank you so much for watching the tutorial. If you want to get the project files for these, they will be available on my Patreon. So thanks to my patrons, I'm actually able to keep this channel up and make more videos for you guys. So you really help me out if you would become a patron. Besides getting the access to all of my project files from my tutorials there, you also get a 15% discount in my Dreadlabs asset web store, as well as a cool Discord role and exclusive channel there. So if you have any tutorial requests, let me know in the comments. And with all of that being said, I just want to thank you for watching. This is Tom from Dreadlabs tuning out, and I'll see you guys in the next video.